welcome back to Resident Evil Village. Time for a big lore dump. Subject name, Salvatore, I don't know, Moreau. Cadeau? I think it's Cadeau. Yeah, Cadeau. I remember because what's-his-face said it. Heisenberg. Cadeau affinity, low. Brain functions, surprisingly low. That's just mean. The Cadeau has caused drastic changes to internal organs, transforming them into organs similar to fish-like gills and a swim bladder. What the hell is a swim bladder? Another subject with irregular cell division, causing him to transform into a giant fish. The subject is unable to control this transformation. Too many defects, an unfit vessel for Eva. Eva? One? Subject name, Alcina Dimitrescu. I know it's apparently pronounced Dimitrescu. I'm gonna keep going with the U. Cadeau affinity, most favorable. Brain functions, normal. Regeneration rate is incredibly fast. The subject can heal any external wound within seconds and grow her nails into claws in mere moments. Rapid regeneration also means an increased body size. Note, due to a hereditary blood disease, the subject must ingest human flesh and blood on a regular basis to maintain regeneration properties. I'm pretty sure it's just blood, and no, there are ways to deal with porphyria that don't require drinking blood. Medical science is amazing like that. I suspect that if the subject's regeneration is not properly balanced, then she may mutate uncontrollably. An unfit vessel for Eva. Carl Heisenberg. No affinity? Incredibly favorable. Brain functions? Normal. Has electric organs similar to the electric ray Narcajaponica. I don't know, an electric eel maybe? These electric organs are connected to... Or maybe it means like a mana ray. I don't know. These electric organs are connected to the subject's nervous system, and therefore pass and control electricity throughout the entire body, allowing control of magnetic fields, which is used to move metal. Splendid specimen, but still an unfit vessel for Eva. Subject name, Donna Beneviento. No affinity, favorable. Brain functions, normal, although severe mental illness. Physically, she's no different from a regular human. However, she can secrete a signal-producing substance which controls plants infected by Munimycete. Plants. Huh. When humans absorb the When humans absorb the pollen from a particular flower, she can cause them to have hallucinations. However, she is mentally underdeveloped and has divided her cadeau among her dolls in order to control them from a distance. An unfit vessel for Eva. Gross. Always check the back. One of these horrible things.
So they're using this to control the bioweapons.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's Evelyn. For those who don't know, Evelyn was the villain of Resident Evil 7. I'm not gonna go into depth on that. I have a lot more for when we actually get to Resident Evil 7. Dear Miranda, my deepest apologies for not meeting you in person. I would love nothing more than to visit your quaint village once more. However, I am incredibly busy. Then again, I suppose for an immortal woman such as yourself, you no longer remember this poor, half-dead medical student in the snow. I've always cherished the revelations I came to 15 years ago when I stayed in your village. I was inspired by your research. Think one could transform a human by infecting them with an organism. Positively visionary. I knew that with that knowledge, I could achieve my own vision for the next step in human evolution. Even after two world wars and humanity on the cusp of another, my conviction never wavered. I realized, however, through the many nights of intellectual talks you and I shared, that your conviction differed from mine. You hope to bring back a single dead person. While I aim to change the world. Your experiments on the mold would not have aided me in my endeavor to achieve an exponential infection. I thought a virus would be more effective. This is why, my dear, I had to leave you. I still regret never telling you goodbye. My apologies for reminiscing. I actually have news that I thought might please you. I found the key to evolution. The progenitor. A virus found in Africa. I plan to start a company with friends and colleagues dedicated to the virus's research. I'll call it Umbrella, just like the symbol in the cave that we spoke about. I am one step closer to making my vision a reality. I hope you will be able to achieve your goal someday. You taught me so much that I will be forever in your debt. Sincerely, your lifelong student, Oswell E. Spencer. Obviously, as that last page confirmed, Spencer is one of the founders of Umbrella. He was a major antagonist that you really never physically saw in any of the games, until he was killed initially off-screen, kind of entirely off-screen, by one of the more prominent series antagonists, Wesker, Albert Wesker, in Resident Evil 5. So we'll get to that, too.
No way.
I don't know what I'm looking at. A wrecking ball? Yeah, that's definitely Evelyn. Giving her a look like she has seen the end of days. Hi, Eva. It's been 100 years since I lost you to the Spanish flu. I was so powerless back then. But now I can bring you back to life from the Mega My seat. I had to test your new vessel's regenerative abilities. Took her apart and revived her in the Mega My seat regulator, the Giant's Chalice. All that is left is to merge her with the Mega My seat. The ceremony can finally begin. For I lost you, I was so stricken with grief that I wandered into a cave to die. So wanted to be with you again. That's when I found it. The Mega My seat, completely by accident. When I touched the black substance, my mind was overcome with knowledge. Mega My seat breaks down and absorbs the consciousness of those who have perished. I knew that if your consciousness was in there too, there would be a way to bring you back. I just needed the right vessel. This is a lot of assumptions for this grand, century-spanning evil plan. When I returned to the village, I implanted the villagers with mold from the Mega My seat. That way I could control them, experiment on them. I experimented on hundreds of people just to find you the perfect vessel. I even tried to increase the efficiency of finding a vessel by creating a parasite I called Cadeau. Yet none of my experiments came to fruition. There were some, like Alcina, who were close to being perfect, but most turned into lichens. I was once approached by an organization who said they would assist me. I gave them some of the mold and your DNA, but all they created was another defect, Evelyn. Then again, not a complete failure. I learned of Rose thanks to them, and I knew she would be the perfect vessel. There was some interference, but I was able to verify her suitability. Now my research is finally complete. Eva, I've waited too long to see you again. Some of those faces look familiar. Not just the one back and to the right of the little girl. What the hell's wrong with that guy's head? You see the guy on the right? What the fuck? I'd say he should see a doctor about that, but they don't seem to care. Well, onward and upward. I guess I probably don't need this. Just in case, though. Sam would be proud. Oh, hey!
Show me your hands. Umbrise, this is Alpha. Where is Miranda right now?
Still at the ceremony site. Whatever she's doing, she's staying put.
God damn. It really is you. I'm glad you saved me. Why are you here?
I was caught in Houston experiments.
Wait, did you say Mia? Mia Winters?
In the flesh. What's the situation up there?
Kind of a war going on. Nothing we can't handle.
Whatever you do, don't tell her Ethan's dead.
Wait. You can't leave me here.
Why not?
You promised, damn it. You said that you would keep us safe. We did everything that you asked. We moved over here, everything! And I didn't care. So long as we were together. So you tell me, where is my husband? Where is my daughter?
Ethan is... gone.
That was your one job, Chris. One job!
I couldn't save him. But I can save Rose. Come on. It's not safe here after all.
What do you mean he's gone?
He's dead. I'm sorry, Mia, but we have to leave. We have to destroy this village.
No! You're wrong.
Explain.
I tried to keep this a secret, but... you don't understand how special he is.
Wait, is Ethan's fucking invulnerability a plot point now? I always thought it was kind of like a morbid joke. It's okay, everybody. I landed right on my healing bottles.
Someone's there? It's cold.
I expected everything would be a lot more blue and windy in the Wraith world.
God, it's freezing. This shit in my body.
You're so dumb.
Huh.
Ellen? How are you here?
You're dead.
I'm surprised that girl sounds exactly the same now as she did in 7.
Miranda.
After 3 years, that's actually rather impressive.
No. I still have to save Rose.
Wrong! It wasn't Miranda. You were always dead.
What are you saying? I can still...
Ow. I landed on the shards of my bottles.
Miranda didn't kill you. You mean you didn't think it was weird? No matter how much you got hurt? Remember.
Apparently you're going to be getting spoilers from 7 here.
3 years ago, the Baker House. You were murdered by Jack. You died there 3 years ago.
That's impossible. No way.
You shouldn't even be able to walk around.
Quit messing with my head.
You shouldn't feet walking.
Funny, I'm not. I'm crawling right now.
Then what am I?
I guess we're a zombie.
I did all that. Rose. Mia. I...
Oh, hey! I just realized his fingers are back.
Now do you get it? Your whole body is nothing but mold.
That makes sense, actually.
You can't ever see your family again.
Family. Family. No. Rose. I have to save my daughter.
You're already dead. Dead.
I will save Rose.
Cheesy as this is, I am eating it up by the pound. Like, that was a great scene. I actually really like the revelation. Not Revelations 1. We don't talk about that one. But I like this revelation. It makes a lot of sense. And I like the show of Ethan's commitment. You got balls, winners. Gigantic, steely balls.
He awakes.
Hey, dude.
Where am I? My carriage, Ethan. You were having a nightmare.
Do I have my fingers back?
Duke? Your battle with Heisenberg was a sight to see.
Yeah, that was awesome, wasn't it?
Show herself.
How long have I been out?
Not long till dawn.
Duke, I need a favor. Take me to Miranda.
I assumed as much and am already on the way. We should arrive shortly.
Why are you so helpful, Duke?
But Ethan, are you sure of this? Your body is, well, falling apart.
Yes.
Yeah, I've looked worse.
Speaking of foolish questions, who or what are you?
Even I can't quite answer that.
Capcom hasn't thought of it yet.
We're here.
I owe you one.
Mr. Winter.
Oh, damn it, my fingers aren't back.
You can't return to your old world any longer. Are you ready?
Yeah, I have to be. I gotta go.
Lock and load. Hell yeah. I guess we're about to go into the final stretch. But I'm gonna cut that for another video. Yeah, this one was nothing but cutscenes and exposition, but I don't care. Thank you all so much for watching, and I hope to see you again next time.